This week's SAP Developer News is full of important updates. Let's get right on to it.
Hey folks, Rich Howman here, developer advocate, SAP Devs. So you guys asked for it, and here it comes. Next Thursday, July 15th, we'll be live streaming an informal discussion all about ABAP. We call it ABAP Past, Present, and Future. DJ Adams, Thomas Young, and myself will be joined by longtime ABAP veterans Boris Gephardt and Carl Kessler, who will share their insights and perhaps some little-known inside stories about the history of ABAP and where it is headed in the future. If you are a fan of ABAP, you don't want to miss this live stream. Check out the SAP Developers YouTube channel for more information.
The new version 2.9 of the Python machine learning client for SAP HANA has been recently released. The client consists of two main parts. One, SAP HANA data frame interface, which provides a set of methods for accessing and querying multimodal data, tabular, but as well connected and spatial, in SAP HANA without bringing the data to the client. Second, a set of machine learning APIs for developing and applying predictive models on the data stored in this database. This release brings a lot of new and enhanced functionality to both parts of the client. Our engineers did a major refactoring of the code, greatly simplifying and enhancing capabilities of working with the multimodal data. For example, when you create a HANA data frame from GeoPandas, the geometry column will be automatically detected and processed as a geometry. You don't need to audit manually anymore. The other example, now in addition to revamped graph algorithms like shortest path or neighbor subgraph, you get new algorithms, shortest path one to all and k shortest path. In machine learning APIs, you will find new methods, like an online version of the linear regression, or a way to detect outliers in datasets based on the results of k-means clustering. If you are using SAP HANA Cloud Services, then you can benefit from data lake support added to the API of the HANA data frames. The link to the complete list of what's new is in the description of this video. Please make sure you check the section of the changes in the APIs there.
With SAP Business Application Studio, it is possible to develop an HTML5 front-end React application and deploy it to SAP BTP Cloud Foundry environment. In his blog post, Yuval Morad explains to you how to create a simple React application which is based on the Material UI framework. The blog post explains how you run the application locally, prepare and build it, to then deploy it to the SAP BTP Cloud Foundry runtime. Also, the integration into SAP Launchpad service is covered. If you want to read the blog post in detail, head over to blogs.sap.com, and the link to the blog post is included in the description of this video.
This week, the general availability of the next-gen experience of the SAP API Business Hub was announced. Back at the end of last year, we saw a beta release with new features including integration discovery and direct consumption in your cloud tenant workspaces. Along with a new look, this next-gen experience brings even more features, including direct consumption of workflow management packages, an enhanced CDS and API resource viewer, and an enhanced set of API test capabilities, along with lots of learning material too. Check out this new next-gen experience at api.sap.com.
Nowadays, it's hard to think of any application that does not make use of notifications in one form or the other, especially in the enterprise context where business entities need to be acknowledged by multiple users. And this is what makes the brand new notification service on SAP BTP so valuable. This allows your application to connect to the service and to order it to create new notifications, which can then be seen by business users in the SAP Fiori Launchpad on SAP BTP. This week, I wrote a blog post about this service, so feel free to check it out and to join the discussion in the comment section below the post.